Okay guys, this is my review for the Infiniti Q30. As you can see, we'll do a quick overview on the outside, then we'll go on the inside, check out the bonnet, underneath with the bonnet, check out the boot as well. So yeah, it's a nice windy, warm day. First of all, I need to give a shout out to Somaliland Honolato, charity shout out. I bought this to represent some help. So yes, shout out to them. Okay, let's go check it out. Okay, we're gonna first of all start from the outside. You can see nice curves, pretty cool in regards with this color. I like it. A lot of similarity to the Mercedes. So there you go, you're nice. I love that when you just get to close the car, the button. Especially, you know, when you're parking your car and you don't know if the car is locked or not. If you see the wing mirrors are closed, it's all good. So let me just open up the car. Let's see. What I like to show, if you drive a Mercedes, you know, you'll recognize these actually buttons. I love the lazy driving. So yes, Mercedes have the gearbox over here. Over here, I found it easier to drive, very spacious. Two places for the bottle, as you can see here, good cubby hole there. Pretty good. I can enjoy as well. Space, it's pretty decent. Let's check out the boot. A lot of people buy this car, wanna see what kind of boot space they're dealing with. So, pretty nice and spacious. Taking a trip to Europe. There you go, there's the Bose. That's the amplifier, pretty nice and spacious. Pretty good. Nice. Now let's go from this side. Check out the space in the back. Now, issue is that little gearbox transmission tunnel, so the person in the middle will actually slightly suffer. But look, you have a nice button there to socket to charge. So if you got kids in the back, don't need to worry about them anymore. And then here from this side, pretty good. AC works like a charm. There you go. And that's cubby hole. It's all good. You can't put a bottle in there, but at least nice space there. Okay, let's check out the engine. Here we go. This is the 1.5 engine, so it's a diesel, so it might be different to the other Mercedes, but actually a lot of the parts you can recognize. What I'm going to find out more about this car is, why are there so many things from Mercedes? There must have been some kind of agreement, like you have with Mazda when they do with the Ford back in the days. Yeah, so pretty cool. Let me check it out quickly to the back so you can see what we're working with. Now remember, this is my driver's seat in the front. So I'm sitting back here, nice and comfortable. I still have space to put my feet underneath the chair, and that's with my position. So if you're a tall driver, you still be able to sit back. And remember, I raised up my seat before, so that's different. So pretty nice and comfortable, but like I mentioned, because of the transmission tunnel in the middle, the passenger in the middle might suffer. But if you go with four people on a trip, you find it very comfortable. You have your electric windows here, so pretty cool. So yeah, good job Infiniti. Alright, final thing I need to give a shout out. You recall I mentioned about how there's so many similarities between Mercedes. For those who drive Mercedes, you recognize this key. So I honestly believe, instead of having the issues you have with German cars, go for Infiniti. Okay, here we go. So I'm now in the Infiniti Q30, which is, you'll see later on when I show you some cool features. It's very Mercedes orientated, from the whole buttons on the steering wheel, and the sat nav is actually done by Infiniti. So this is the luxury brand of Nissan. It's a diesel, it drives very smooth. I like the way it pulls. Put my foot down and slight delay, but then it really pulls.
In 200 yards, speed camera.
Okay, oh look at that, look at that. I mean, I got spoiled by Google, but now this sat nav tells me all I think what's going on. And also, I forgot, it has some different sport modes. So right now, I'm in sport, put my foot down. Yep,
I can feel the difference now. Yeah, sweet. Manchester has changed as a city. I mean, like, come on, now we have roads doing, how would you say, 20 miles. But yeah, one thing I do forget, I'm not used to this, it actually has gear changes through the steering wheel. So I'm a bit old school. Let's see, where am I? Let me just go back to my normal driving, lazy driver, okay? I'm gonna stick to let the car drive for me. The AC on this is top notch. Top. I mean, I never thought Manchester would actually ever get hot, but it's still this kind of sticky, humid weather we're living in. So yeah, I'm loving the AC. This is why my windows are nice and closed. It has some good spots for the bottle, so I'll show you that later on when I'm driving, after I stop driving, that is. It's a nice lazy drive. You get to enjoy. I get a nice kind of high view, so I put my seat all the way up, so I like to see the curves of the bonnet when I'm actually driving. And I still have good headroom space. So even though this one's got the panoramic roof, it doesn't open, which is a slight issue for me. But hey, at least I get to see when it's raining and just enjoy. AC is really nice and cold. Honestly, I think I might bring it down to AC. It's just a bit too cold. But then I'll just adjust that. Ah, sweet. And then now, basically, I'm just right now enjoying the drive. It has cruise control. Good thing about this car, like the Lexus, it has a radar cruise control, which is really nice. And it's funny because, like Lexus, the UK do not like these cars. They're not a big fan. They love their, how would you say, their German cars, and they simply actually are doing, they don't give it not that much same respect, you know? So as a result of it, you don't get to see that many car. If you have this car in the UK, you stand out. Like with certain Lexuses, but even though they're slowly getting there. But a car that's diesel, people don't like diesel now. It's like kind of the no word. They're simply saying, oh. But let's be honest, if you're taking a trip down to Europe and you want to enjoy a car that's comfortable with AC and cruise control with all the cool toys, then you need to go for diesel. And I bet in a few years' time, they're going to turn around and say, oh, well, we want to go back to diesel because petrol, we found some new issue. But hey, let me get back to the car review. Yes, so steering wheel buttons are all nice and easy to access. I have my volume here. I can just put the volume up anytime. Yeah, this is some good radio here. Yeah, that's my girl, Destiny Channel. Yeah. Anyway, back to the thing. All the axes are here. So like with Mercedes, so you'll see when I show you later on, the whole dashboard, very close. I mean, I was told as well that this car has Mercedes parts. So when I pop the bonnet later on, I'm actually going to see what kind of parts are we dealing with. So it's smart. Infiniti are smart. I mean, everyone loved Mercedes. So it's kind of a, you know, if you're not a bad snob, then you want to look how different, then this is the car I would go for. For me, I'm always a Japanese fan, so Lexus is my number one choice, but Infiniti I've always admired from the distance. So when I had this opportunity to drive this car, I was over the moon because I get to enjoy. I mean, people now are loving the whole GLA and A-Class, and this car was designed to try and compete with that area. So it's pretty good. Leg room in the back is pretty spacious. I'm actually going to try it out and sit in the back. The driver's seat position here, I'm able to put my elbow here nice and comfortable. I like the kind of center console. It has two cubby holes. Yep, I can a little spot to put a few things. The side pocket, I thought they would have a space for a bottle, but hey, I can live with it. I'm able to at least put my phone there. Front window, nice and spacious. I can see everything. There's nothing like with some cars, you see the pillar kind of blocks your vision. But with this car, it's pretty nice. So yeah, that's a good plus on the Infiniti side. Thing, what I'm probably gonna do is try and actually see the turning, how it does from turning side. I always like to test the cars, how it turns. Ah, nice and smooth. I mean, this is what, 2017? So it's pretty smooth in regards to and how would you say, driving. I'm just getting myself used to Manchester roads. Everything has changed. This is the famous Oxford Road I'm coming up to, where I used to live and the get my pizza and everything. So now I'm trying to guess what, there's no more left turn back. I need to now take a right. Wow, things have definitely changed. So at least you guys get to view how Manchester's changed. Ah, this is some memory. That's where I think Barclays Bank used to be in here. Yeah, Barclays Bank, that's my cash machine back in the days, man. Damn. But yes, if you live in London, maybe diesel's not the car for you. Yeah, you stick with the hybrids. But outside of London, then you might as well stick with a diesel, because I don't know what's going to happen with Brexit and everything, but it looks like we won't get to have our little escapes to Europe anymore. So, this guy's doing a dangerous move, man. You're not meant to go left, man. Go straight. Yeah, so I'm going to take a right now, because apparently this guy, like me, he's kind of used to the streets. So here, this is my spot back in the days of student days. Let's see. I used to have... Oh, Popolino, you're still open, mate. Hey, old Saints, man. Look.
200 yards.
Let's see what
speed
she said.
Camera.
Thanks again. So yes, make sure if you get yourself an Infiniti, go for the fuller load of... And how is it? Version. Wow. I'm sorry. It's hard to concentrate on this car review when I'm just admiring how the city has completely changed. But back to the car review. It's actually a very smooth car. It flows well on the road. I'm able to turn easy. I'll do a quick test to see how it does on the 3-point turn. So we'll try that out. And I like, because I'm going for the comfortable, easy drive. So let's imagine I am in here. There's a car behind me. I'll do my 3-point turn somewhere else. But I'm just loving the drive. So yeah, this car actually comes in different colors. This one is the, I think it's called Midnight Black, or I'm just making up this color name. But no, it's very comfortable. You have all your buttons here. It has a nice retractable mirrors. I like pressing those buttons. Yeah. And I'm just admiring how they say things. I shouldn't be admiring, like, you know, the drive. But yeah, definitely for people who are looking for a reliable Japanese diesel, then you should look at it. We'll see what Infiniti is going to do for the long term. This guy can't even park in. But basically, let's see. Can I take a right here? Ah, it's just a left here. It's a no entry. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do is actually just pretend I'm going to turn right in here. Just to help the turning. Ah, nice. It's got a good turning. The gearbox being on the center allows a lot of room to do other things. So it really gives you the space for how would you say, easy and... Okay, come on, mate. I'm parked up so you can have space. And let this guy overtake me. Yeah, I can see you, mate. Just because you're driving Lexus doesn't mean you don't know how to drive. Go, whatever, mate. Don't even know how to drive. Some people. Yeah, here we go. Now, it's got no reverse camera, but it has a nice reverse sensor, so you can't go wrong as you do. I wouldn't say illegal 3-point turns, but I would just say much needed 3-point turns. Pretty useful. Yeah, Manchester as a city has changed. Before, people were much more polite, but looks like they've become more like London people. Too impatient, despite me indicating. Let me move a bit back because I keep clear road. It's like the amount of looks I've gotten in this car, I think it's kind of a street cred, and people are admiring it from the distance. They're trying to guess it. Is it a Mazda? Is it a Lexus? What is this car? It's an Infiniti. I think Lexus Infiniti are pretty big in the US. People know they want cars that are fully loaded and reliable. So I think if you buy yourself Infiniti, you'll be different from the Jones, from your neighbors. Everyone will know. Okay, this guy knows what he's talking about now. So yeah, it's pretty good. Manchester honestly has changed. Oh, that's my old uni bed. Are they doing refurbishment or they're making apartments? Wow. Honestly, I don't even recognize the city anymore. Pretty cool. But yeah, later on, what I'm going to do, I'm going to just film the car. Now, some people might not like the sound of a diesel, but to be honest, is if you want quiet, then go for a hybrid, but then you miss the power. And always I tell people, when you're buying a car, if it's going to be a hybrid, make sure you keep it for a long time, because the amount of money you're paying up front. And it's the same thing with now, even with electric cars. You get yourself a Tesla, yes, great. You are, you know, one in a million. But the amount of money you spend on it, unless you actually use it for business, Oh, you don't drive that. People in London, yes, hybrid and electric, go for it. Outside of London, unless, I think they try to bring the congestion in once in Manchester, then thankfully we said no. But I'm sure they'll try and bring it again. But yeah, it's a car for all occasion. I love the sound on it, because for me, like, if you recall, my Lexus has the Mark Levinson, which is a top-notch radio. Infiniti don't mess about. They went and they got the famous Bose. So I just put it. Hey. Perfect timing right there. Perfect. Ooh, like I said, it's got some real good sound on this place. So even if you're a mother with kids, one or two is good. If you're a young man who want to stand out from your boys, this is a good car. If you want to look different from all those A classes and all those GLA, get yourself the Infiniti. You're actually enjoying a comfortable car that looks different, and also it ticks the box in regards to economically wise, because you save money. So with these other cars are petrol, so, but I do have to check up on this whole DPF side of it. I think they've changed it. So back in the days, if you had a diesel, once in a while you need to drive for 30-40 miles just to make sure it doesn't clog up. So if you have that, try and, you know, it's an excuse for you to go drive. So in Manchester, I used to go drive to Chester, enjoy the sights, or drive to the nearby and lakes near, you know, after Stockport Hook. That's a good place. But if not, go to Liverpool. If you're not a big fan of Liverpool, there are other places in the northwest you can actually enjoy. Blackpool. Yeah, don't forget Blackpool. Yeah. But anyway, and I actually recommend this car. I like it. I have now have another choice besides Lexus, because Lexus, after a while, they started to make the cars look a bit funky. So I'm not gonna pay amount of money of a Range Rover for a car that looks a bit funky. So yes, Infiniti, you've now entered my world, and recommend it. Okay guys, like always, if you like what you see, share with your friends. Till the next time, peace and love, and enjoy the drive.